गुड मॉर्निंग। सो टुडेज टॉपिक इन मार्केटिंग इज पोर्टफोलियो। पोर्टफोलियो इज़ अ फाइनेंशियल टर्म डोनेटिंग अ कलेक्शन ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट हेल्ड बाय एन इन्वेस्टमेंट कंपनी, हेगल्स फंड, फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूट और इंडिविजुअल। द टर्म पोर्टफोलियो रेफर टू एन कलेक्शन ऑफ फाइनेंशियल असेट्स सच एज स्टॉक, बॉन्ड एंड कैश। Portfolio may be held by individual investor and or managed by financial profession, hedge fund, bank and other financial institute. It is generally accepted principle that a portfolio is designed according to the investor's risk tolerance, time frame and investment objective. A grouping of financial assets like as stock, bond and cash equivalent as well as their mutual exchange tracked and closed fund counterpart portfolio are held directly by investor or managed by financial professional. Next is portfolio analysis. Portfolio analysis described as evaluating process of reviewing the holding of an entire investment portfolio. Each asset must be involving for performance, asset allocation, diversification, variation and the portfolio beta test portfolio strength. Portfolio analysis also investigate the risk associated with the present portfolio composition. Mitigating risk is an indispensable component of the portfolio management. Portfolio analysis is a process of looking at every investment held with a portfolio and involving how it affect the all over performance. Portfolio analysis risk to determine the variation of each security, the overall beta of the portfolio, the amount of diversification and the asset allocated within the portfolio. The analysis seek to understand the risk associated with the current composition of the portfolio and identify way to mitigate the identified risk. Next is modern portfolio. Modern portfolio theory relies on diversification to minimize individual security risk in a portfolio. The idea is that by holding a large number of different securities, no individual securities can seriously affect the performance of the portfolio and the investor is left with only systemic risk, which is the risk that the entire sector or market will decline. It is possible to hedge against systemic risk, but it cannot be fully mitigated without giving up a significant portion of the potential return. Asset allocation. Asset allocation is the second part of reducing risk. An investor can hold 200 different securities in his portfolio, but if they are all in one sector, he will be seriously exposed to the systemic risk of the individual sector. To mitigate the systemic risk of a sector, investor look to allocate different portion of their portfolio into different sector and assessed classes. The example is given here, you can see. Next is after assessed allocation and the diversification are determined, the variation of each security is examined. Variation in the rate at which the value of an investment fluctuate around an average. The greater the variations, the greater the risk associated with the investment. Beta. Using an investment's variation, its beta can be calculated. Beta is a useful measure of how much variation exists for an individual security compared to an existing portfolio or benchmark. An investment beta is an easy way to see if adding the security to an existing portfolio will reduce the risk associated with the portfolio or will increase the risk. A beta of less than 1 will lower the risk, while a beta of greater than 1 will increase the risk. Next is risk analysis. Risk analysis refers to the uncertainty of the forecasted फ्यूचर कैश फ्लोज स्ट्रीम वेरिएशन ऑफ पोर्टफोलियो स्टॉक रिटर्न स्टैटिकल एनालिसिस टू डिटरमाइन द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ अ प्रोजेक्ट सक्सेस और फेलियर एंड पॉसिबल फ्यूचर इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस रिस्क एनालिस्ट ऑफ अ वर्क इन टैंडम विद फोरकास्टिंग प्रोफेशनल टू मिनिमम फ्यूचर नेगेटिव अनफोर्सीन इफेक्ट टाइप ऑफ रिस्क सिस्टमिक रिस्क एंड अनसिस्टमिक रिस्क सिस्टमिक रिस्क अनकंट्रोलेबल बाय एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन मैक्रो इन नेचर अनसिस्टमिक रिस्क इज कंट्रोलेबल बाय ऑर्गेनाइजेशन माइक्रो इन नेचर सिस्टमिक रिस्क इज ड्यू टू द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ एक्सटर्नल फैक्टर्स ऑन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सच एज फैक्टर आर नॉर्मली अनकंट्रोलेबल From an organization point of view, it is macro in nature as it affects a large number of organizations operating under a similar scheme or same domain. It can be planned by the organization. Systemic risk. It may be internal rate risk, market risk, purchase power risk. Next is unsystemic risk is due to the influence of internal factors prevailing within an organization. Such factors are normally controllable from an organization point of view. It is macro in nature as it affects only a particular organization. It can be planned so that necessary action can be taken by the organization to mitigate the risk. Next is the risk management of prioritization process is followed where by the risk with the greatest loss or impact and the greatest probability of occurring are handled first and risk with low probability of occurrence and lower loss are handled in decreasing order. In practice, the process of assessing overall risk can be difficult and balancing resource used to mitigate between risk with a high probability of occurrence but lower loss versus a risk with high loss but lower probability of occurrence can often be mishandled. Portfolio analysis offers the following advantage. It encourages management to evaluate each of the organization business individually and to set objective and allocate resource for each. It stimulates the use of external oriented data to supplement management intuitive judgment. It raises the issues of cash flow availability for use in expansion and growth. Portfolio analysis does, however, have been limitations. And the limitations are it is not easy to define product or market segment. It provides an illusion of scientific rigor when some subjective judgment are involved. So portfolio management philosopher has given definition is enable strategic planner to select the optimal strategies for the individual products with this achieving overall corporate object and multiple location. It is the strategical unit that make up the company and the attempt to evaluate current effectiveness and vulnerability. So here we have completed this portfolio topic. For any inquiry, you can comment below. Thank you.